Today we're going to talk about the second most expensive spice in the world next to saffron. You have any idea what it is? It's more common than you might have guessed. Today's sponsor is Brent and Sam's Cookies. You can check them out online at brentandsams.com. Brent and Sam's Pure Naturals are a whole line of gourmet cookies. They come in all different flavors. This is their key lime white chocolate. I also have their ginger spice. And I think that my favorite so far is their triple chocolate bliss. As you can see, I've been snacking away on them. Their key is that nothing is artificial. No preservatives, no high fructose corn syrup. They bake their cookies with a slow baking process that kind of lets everything caramelize and come together. And the result is a crunchy, but also kind of soft cookie. It's a great dipping cookie, like you're gonna watch a movie and dip it in some milk. Amazing. And you know, they're really enjoyable. I enjoy them a lot. I'm going to give away a few boxes of them because they sent me so many. I want to share them with you guys. So what you can do is go to danieldelaney.com/Brent and Sam's to enter to win. I'm going to give them away in about 2 or 3 days from now, but the details will be on the website. And until then, you can find them in your local grocery store, or you can check them out online at brentandsams.com. Get your hands on their delicious cookies today. All right, so the topic at hand today is vanilla. Now, the vanilla pod that you might have used in some cooking or vanilla extract is actually native to Mexico. It's actually the pod of an orchid, just like the decorative orchids that you have around your house, except for this is the vanilla orchid and it grows in a vine. When Spanish explorers started to explore Mexico, they discovered the plant, took it back to Europe, and tried to grow it. But they were unable to reach homeostasis, the plant never produced pods, and they didn't know why. One day they found out that there was one critical component missing, bees. The vanilla orchid has both sexes on each plant, but it needs a little help to, you know, do its business. And bees are the missing link. Bees go into one end of the plant, grab some pollen, and deposit it in the other side of the plant, thus fertilizing the plant. It wasn't until a young boy discovered that he could actually extract the pollen with his finger and stick it into the other end of the plant and actually pollinate the plants artificially himself. Once that was discovered, the vanilla plant was shipped to multiple parts of the world, and one part in particular really took to it, which is the island of Madagascar off the coast of Africa. In fact, to this day, Madagascar produces the majority of vanilla for the world, making up a total of 80% of the world's consumption of vanilla. Now, there are a number of different species of vanilla, and they all have mildly different flavors. Some can be a little bit more smoky, some can be a little bit more floral, but they all have a very similar flavor profile. They taste like vanilla, and it's a wonderfully unique flavor that is hard to replicate with anything else. Vanilla is commonly used in baking. It's also used in cosmetics as well as perfumery. And one of the most popular ways to have vanilla is through a liquid called vanilla extract. Vanilla extract is basically the flavor of the vanilla bean extracted and added to a liquid. This, like vanilla, can be expensive to purchase. However, if you make it from scratch at home, you can kind of keep refilling this extract and flavoring more and more bits of vanilla liquid from the vanilla pod that you bought just once. So I'm going to show you just how you can do that at home. To make vanilla extract at home, pour a 200 milliliter bottle of vodka into a measuring cup. Split 2 or 3 large whole vanilla beans in half to expose the seeds. Place the vanilla beans in a bottle and pour back the vodka, leaving some space at the top. Shake it and put it in a dark space. Your kitchen cabinet will work perfectly. Then once a week for about 8 weeks, grab the bottle and give it a shake or two, put it back in the cabinet. After 8 weeks, you will have home-brewed vanilla extract that tastes just as good, if not better, than anything you will buy at the store. This is my vanilla extract that I've been working on for about 8 weeks now. It smells just like vanilla extract that you'd get at the store. I guess you could drink it and kind of get messed up, but I'd rather cook with it. You can just start to add more vodka to this as it goes down in size, and when it finally starts to lighten up, you've sucked the life out of your vanilla, it's time to get new pods, but that will take a little while. Tune in tomorrow for another What's This Food. Be sure to check out our sponsor, brentandsams.com. You can enter to win some cookies from our site by going to danieldelaney.com danieldelaney.com/Brent and Sam's, and leave me a comment. Let me know what you think of the show. We're just about at the middle point, unless we actually passed it. So we're almost halfway done with the show. It's a great show. We're having a lot of fun doing it, but I love hearing from you guys. So leave me comments, drop me emails, and I will see you tomorrow.